Hi, I'm Linda Matthews, and in this video, I'll be showing you my new Junk Journal Elements, Embellishments, and Shapes template bundle. This template bundle includes 11 pages of Junk Journal Elements and Shapes, such as pockets, envelopes, tags, cards, and more. This is a great template bundle that you can use over and over again to create a variety of different elements and embellishments for all your junk journals. The Elements and Shapes templates come in two formats. The PDF format is easy to print and can be used with your own printable papers or scrapbook papers. Or you can use the PNG format in a photo editing program, which gives you more creative options for designing using digital papers. Included are two styles, one with a border for a vintage style finish and one with no border for a clean edge finish. To print using your own paper, open one of the PDF template files. Make sure the page scaling option is set to none so that the template prints at the correct size. Insert a sheet of printable paper or scrapbook paper into your printer and then print the template page. The PDF templates are quick and easy to use. However, you have more options for creating unique designs when using the PNG format files. To get started designing using the PNG format files, open one of the templates in your photo editing program. I'm using Photoshop Elements, however you could also use Photoshop, Photopea, or even Canva. Now add a digital paper and move it to a layer underneath the template layer. I'm using a collage-style digital paper. Using these types of papers, you can quickly create elements that have different patterns, but overall they coordinate in style and colour. You can resize and move the paper around and even use multiple papers to align the pattern within the individual elements. If there is any overlap, add a layer mask and brush away the excess. Using a layer mask, you can hide any unwanted areas on your design. To add a layer mask, select the layer, then click the layer mask icon. Select the brush tool and the color black, and then brush over the overlapping area that you want to hide. The great thing about using the PNG templates is that you can add different papers to different sections of the template in order to change the color and design. Just make sure to place the papers on a layer underneath the template and then position them wherever you want. Once you've completed your design, be sure to save the file in JPEG format for easy printing. When designing the specimen frames, you can add a digital clip art to the center of each of the cards. Just make sure that the clip art fits within the boundary of the frame. Once the page is printed and cut, the cards will be placed into the specimen frame pocket to display the clip art. Once the designs are completed, print each of the pages onto a sheet of cardstock. For some of the pages, you may want to print a full page design on the back. Depending on the size of your journal, you may want to resize these printables slightly smaller, and this is easy to do. For these large pocket templates, I've designed them at 8 inches high to suit larger journals, but my journal cover is about 7 inches high, so I'm going to print them smaller. You can easily print smaller by simply resizing the document if you're using a photo editing program. You can resize by adjusting the document width and height, or by percentage. However, I always like to compile my files into a PDF document before printing, because it's much easier to manage the files when they're in this particular format. To resize using a PDF file, open the Print dialog box. Select Tile Large Pages, then set the percentage scale. Your settings may be different to mine depending on your PDF reader, but you'll have a similar setting. To print these pockets at approximately 7 inches high, I've set to print at 85%. Once the pages are printed, cut out all the pieces. Then crease and fold along the fold lines and tabs. Some of the pages will require assembly. Thank you. This double pocket includes 6 round buttons that you can use for closures. To make the button closures for the pocket, stack 3 round buttons on top of each other and glue them together. Then run some ink from an ink pad around the outside edges. Punch a small hole in the center of each button using a bookbinding awl or some other pointed tool, just large enough to be able to push through a brad fastener. Using a pencil, make a mark along the center on the outside of each of the flaps. Then make a mark along the center on the inside of each pocket, 1.5 inches down from the top edge. Using the bookbinding awl, punch holes through each of the marks on the pockets and attach the buttons. Attach an eyelet through each of the marks on the flaps. To finish the closures, thread a piece of ribbon through the eyelets just long enough to wrap around the buttons. For the large pockets, you can use them individually or you can stack them, the narrow pocket on top of the wider pocket. These large pockets are ideal for the front and back covers. Now that everything is cut and assembled, there's lots of different elements and embellishments to include in your junk journal. I've made this no-sew junk journal using the junk journal cover and page template set. I've made the cover using the quarter-inch spine templates, and I've wrapped a length of wide ribbon around enough to make two signatures. I've used three double pages per signature.